Hey guys, I'm Victor Barrero Jr. and this is Nadine Passes, our reviewer. And we're here to talk about
Horizon Zero Dawn.
So today we're going to give you a brief tour of what you can do in Horizon Zero Dawn, as well as give you a bit of an outlook of what you can expect when you're in the game world, such as tips and tricks and other sorts of little info.
Alright, so we're going to start first with Meridian Gate. Now, this is the city of Meridian. So, the city of Meridian is basically one of the biggest settlements in Horizon Zero Dawn. Now, I'm not going to show you too much of the Meridian city because I don't want to spoil you guys. So I'm just going to start here at the outskirts of the gate. So this is the gate. And once you enter here through this bridge, this is when you will see most of the main quest points. Now, if I share too much of this, then you're probably going to end up getting spoiled. So I'm just going to cross this bridge. And I just want to show you quickly how beautiful Horizon Zero Dawn is. Look at this. Look at the vistas there. There's so much to see here in Horizon Zero Dawn. So this is just one quarter, I guess. This environment here, this summer jungle look here, this is just one quarter of the game. Once you head to the map, which I will quickly share with you, this is the map of the game. It's this big. It may not seem so big, like as big as Skyrim's, but the amount of things that you can do in this game is intense. Now this part is clouded, because we haven't reached the area yet. I've finished this game, but there's still so much to unlock, and I don't want you guys to miss some of these easily skippable areas or skippable quests. So I'm going to show you later how to get to one of these cauldrons. Now this cauldron right here, this is basically, if you complete this area here, you can basically unlock one of the override sections. If you are already in the part of the game where you can override machines, where you can basically control them, then heading to one of these cauldrons is essential because they will unlock more machines for you to control and override.
Alright. So, why don't you show them some of the activities you can do while we head over there to the cauldron?
Alright. So, we are going to go on a fast travel here to one of these areas. This is a bandit camp, which we unlocked earlier before we started the live stream. So I'm gonna fast travel here. Right. Now it's important to note that when you fast travel, it's not that easy here in Horizon Zero Dawn. You're gonna have to craft fast travel packs in order for you to switch from one place to another if you're in a hurry.
So in other words, it's a sort of like food and shelter that you need to while you're doing your walking, so to speak.
Yeah. So basically, you're gonna have to hunt for animal skins, get some ridgewood, early stuff, so you can switch from one place to another if you're in a hurry. But I encourage you to avoid fast traveling because this game just has so much to offer. You don't want to skip anything. So we're just gonna wait for it to load.
That said, by the way, once you get to certain campfires, like this one over here, this is actually one of the liberated settlements. It used to be filled with bandits, now they're all dead, so other people have moved in. Good for them.
Alright, so we're gonna make our way. I'm going to quickly just make a waypoint here so we don't get lost. So we're just gonna quickly make our way to the cauldron so that... And while we head on our way there, we're just gonna collect some stuff, probably hunt some animals to collect more stuff, so that we're well equipped when we get to the cauldrons. Cauldrons are not exactly the easiest walk in the park type of levels in this game, so you wanna be well prepared. So right here, what you're seeing right now is those. I forgot what it's called.
They're called tall necks.
Tall necks, which is the giraffe looking ones you've seen in the trailers. So, quick fact about these tall necks. If you climb one of those and override these tall necks, you can basically unlock the area. Not unlock, but remove the fog of war in the area. So you can see what the area has to offer. Right. So, where we're going, where the waypoint is telling us.
And a longer night ahead.
And as you can see, there are also smaller enemies along the way.
This one is a watcher. So, you know what, let's just try it. Let's just It's just there.
Oh, he's scanning. Shoot him in the eye. There you go.
He one-shot them in the eye. They're basically dead. Immediately. He's gonna collect metal shards and wire. So, it looks easy, of course, if you already are at a high level. But the more you explore this game, the more you find scarier, bigger creatures. We might meet a Thunderjaw along the way, I'm not entirely sure.
Thunderjaws are the equivalent of what exactly in the real world?
I don't think there is an equivalent. I've never seen that. Perhaps a rhinoceros would be something I would think of.
Okay.
But
a rhinoceros with jaws.
Yes, with jaws and really huge machine guns and laser guns strapped to their backs. So
that's not inviting at all.
Yeah, they are quite intimidating when you see them at first. But you know, if you play this game enough, you'll probably get Aloy's hunting instincts, and hopefully you'll have an easier time. By the way, you can also kill live animals, so we're just gonna kill that.
Yep. That's 40 experience points to kill a turkey. And over there is...
I think we have found a ravager. Let us... Okay, I'm gonna... Oh, this is a sawtooth. Okay. So a sawtooth is basically a...
Saber-toothed tiger?
Yes, not. Close enough. It's like a little brother of the Thunderjaw. So, if we find the Thunderjaw, you'll see what I mean. But let's see if we can take down this sawtooth. So I'm gonna use Aloy's array of tools with me right now. We're gonna start with a shock wire. Right. So I'm gonna sneak in. Slowly.
I know how
use
to
our focus to find
tooth.
Out its track.
I'm getting close.
We're gonna highlight the track right here. So we know where he's going. He doesn't seem to have a straight track. He doesn't have a complete track. Oh, there we go. There we go. So, alright. So he's circling around this area. So we're gonna prepare in advance. Hopefully, I do not screw this up. I'm gonna put in a track here. There. Our rope caster. Okay, there we go. I'll use our rope caster to pin him down so he doesn't get to move that much. Alright. What should do? Alright. Then we're gonna use our hardpoint arrows. Basically, try to take off as much component as we can get so that he is weakened by the time he stands up. Mark. Oh, okay, I did not see that. Aha.
It's the wolf got the other one down.
Yeah. You just need to be aware. About the other one. Yeah, yeah. You're gonna have to breathe.
Oh! Did he just hit the other one?
Yeah. They can hurt each other.
Nice, friendly fight.
This is not a good a smart approach. Let's see if we can override this. Hide the bushes here. Let's see. I don't think it can. Okay. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try overriding one of them. They're running away. Interesting. Why?
Oh. Maybe are they not looking for you?
They are, but they're looking at the wall. Over here, bros. Come here. Let's try making them fight one of them. See, this is what I like about this game. They're never really predictable. I've had one smaller creatures like the Strider, and they're supposed to be the skittish animals. I hit one of them, one of the herds, and
did they run you over?
One of them ran me over. The rest ran away, and I didn't see the other one who was brave enough to try and take me down. So I appreciate that. All right. If I recall correctly, I was able to unlock the override for the sawtooth. So let's just do that because they're
that should be one of the starter ones.
I think if you find the second cauldron, you can find a way to override this guy. So we're gonna wait. In my first playthrough, I didn't even see these cauldrons. I skipped them. So I didn't know this was possible. So let's override. There we go. There we go. So let's see now if we can find. See if we can find a friend. Where's your friend? There we go. Let's provoke him. He has such a. He came from such a far distance, I didn't catch him. Let's use a position.
I'm using the fire bolt.
No. He's gonna run here. Run here! Alright. Over here. Yep. There we go. Over here! Friendo. There we go. Come on. You just ran away. That is useless. Okay. No. We got this.
Maybe he's running back.
There we go.
There we go. He ran back this
path. He's still attacking me though. Gonna hide. Watch this action happen. There we go. Oh, he still sees me.
Well.
Defend me, my friend.
As long as he doesn't run over you, I'm trying to protect you.
No, he's not gonna.
Maybe you should help him out?
Yeah. There we go. I died.
Oh boy. Yeah. That was unexpected.
Nah, it's easy. I just didn't catch the second one.
Luckily though, the load times are pretty good.
For a big game like this, this is actually fast. Even when I downloaded it, it was like 30, 40 gigabytes. I recall non-open world games being like having bigger download sizes, like 70, 80 gigabytes.
Yeah.
All right.
I think Final Fantasy is at least 50 now. Final Fantasy 15 is 50 gigs. That's hard drive space.
That is huge. See, that's why I just bought the physical game. Anyway, gotta figure out where we are.
Oh, we're back in the compound.
Yeah. Let's just skip that part.
Maybe we can go to the.
Oh,
never mind.
Too late. Sorry. I think what we can do is we can go back to that area and see.
Or we just head to the cauldron.
Yeah, we can do that too. But I really want to take down that sawtooth. That was annoying. I didn't perceive that there would be two of them. Just one.
Oh well, you can give them payback later.
Yeah. Once I figure out how to override more, maybe we can go back. You should be. Yeah, there. Oh, there they are. Oh no, those are long legs. Those are long legs. Lance horns and. Ah, so this is a really infested area. You can see that at night. Alright. We'll get back in here.
By the way, what is that thing you're doing with the blue sphere?
Oh, this is called the focus. Basically, you'll get this really early on. When you use the focus, you can track different. Animals, creatures, they can tell you what it is, the weaknesses and all that. So, such as this one, the Lance Horn. Its weakness is basically tear damage. So, to figure out, yes, so these arrows already have icons to show you what kind of abilities they have. So, this Tear Blast arrow makes tear damage, which is perfect for the Lance Horn. Or later. We're gonna go back to them later. Let's not waste time dying too much in this stream. And let's go and focus. Head to the cauldron right here. Oops. There we go. You can actually get a mount.
You're able to override certain machines.
Yes. So, we weren't able to get one because we couldn't find a Strider nearby. So,
Strider is the horse-looking one?
Yeah. You can mount different kinds of machines, like the Strider. There's another one with horns, which I keep forgetting their names. We'll see them later.
Grazer?
No, it's not Grazers. Grazers are... Razors are like the Lance ones. Yeah, those are the ones that look like gears. You can't mount them though. It, we got a couple of watchers here. Should be easy enough to. I shouldn't screw this up.
Time to keep the upper hand.
Hey. Alright, that's all of it, right?
You screwed that up?
No, I did.
In the middle of that.
The it's amazing how, you know, this game actually reminds me of Bloodborne. Or not really Bloodborne. Just the saving part. Because you can't really save anything unless you go through those bonfires. So it does remind you of Dark Souls. You notice how when she melees, there is no lock on to this. Your melee attacks.
Yeah, it just auto attack.
Yeah. It's like a magnet. See? Is if I go stealthy, if I do the stealthily, it will take some time. So let's rush that. Freeze coils. Freeze coils are basically modifications for your weapons. Yeah, sure. So this is what they look like. So when you go to the menu, you can go check out crafting, and you can put in some modifications. The modifications I have for this bow. Damage coil and damage coil and the handling coil, which basically makes it easier for you to aim. The weapons I'm using right now is the Shadow Hunter bow. It's one of the higher level hunter bows that you can get from merchants. They're not really higher level, it's just they cost a lot. And also the Karja Sharpshot bow.
So are there different types of ranged weapons in the game?
Yes, we got the basic, not really basic, Shadow Hunter bow, which is the one that we will always use. Then this one is for more precision type attacks. So for example, you want to get you want to destroy a certain component of a machine before taking them down head on. So you want to use the Karja Sharpshot bow for that. Then we have the Tripcaster, which was basically what I used earlier to take
the tripwire thing.
Yeah, the tripwire. Right. It's basically like a trap. The ones that we saw earlier with the failed attempt to get down that sawtooth, and then you get the rope caster to bring to take them down. There's also the sling, which is basically for elemental AoE type damage. So, oh look, we got resources. This is basically the game telling me to pack up because there's a. Looks like it's gonna be.
Brew that up later.
White. Oh, there's another one there.
Yeah, it looks like. Looks like the entrance.
Oh, that is the entrance. Right. Okay. So, this is where.
Oh.
Whoa! Interesting. Oh, okay, we gotta go down here.
That caught me by surprise.
I think.
No, there should be a way down there to the left, right?
Yeah, I want to see what this is for. So.
Unless you shoot that.
There should be a way. Right.
Oh, okay.
So we can go down from here. I'm gonna activate that to make sure I'm not lost. Okay, drop that bitch. Make sure I get to bring all the herbs
some
I can get.
Some kind of liquid flowing through that pipe.
See that? Okay. It's interesting to note that there are two ways for you to heal up in this game. You can get medicine, herbs, and you can also craft potions. So I would assume that the medicine herbs are the easier way to do that. that.
Although it takes longer to...
It takes longer for you to heal up, but that's the quickest way for you to collect or to get. Because with potions, you still have to craft them. So if you're in a... You know, if you feel like you're in an unlucky place, then try to find as many herbs as you can.
So if the herbs are more of a heal over time,
looks like I'm not the
potions are like instantaneous.
Yes.
No waste.
Type of
press of a button type of healing.
Alright.
Interesting. So okay. So this is literally the first time I'm seeing this.
Wow. Same here.
Cause yeah, again, these are things that are so easy to skip if you're really not paying attention to what's on the map.
Need them soon enough.
The game is interesting because it basically gives you a lot of information,
prepared.
But it doesn't tell you what to do with it.
Oh, that's enough.
So there's a bit of a challenge, and it really encourages you to explore more. So we're going to enter the cauldron right now. I'm not gonna talk much about what you can. Get from just seeing this, but basically look at the contrast between where we were, you know, where we were, the outside world, the more nature friendly, the more green environment, into this gray, cold, futuristic vibe.
That circular device, what does it do?
Chelsea, zoom that in. Turbine, rotating transformer of universe polarity. So
looks like things are going my
then
way.
Then you can probably climb up that.
Then we can switch. Okay, and interesting.
That rushing sound.
All the nooks and crannies, you can find a lot of things.
So what are the objective of the cauldrons anyway?
So cauldrons basically upgrade your override tool. Did you see the override tool that we used with the sawtooth earlier?
So the mind control bit, right?
Yeah, yeah. You can basically control more machines as you go through these cauldrons. So at the end of this, I'm expecting that there's gonna be a certain type of machine that we have to override. And once we override that, we're gonna have to take every enemy down. Once we do that, that's when we unlock the override information. The override information. Is that one? This guy's gonna just go for me right now. Hey! Bye! Take those. Yep. If we have another enemy. This is Ravager. Okay, Ravager's kind of tough.
That thing looks like a sawtooth. But heavily armed. Great.
I'm gonna use a tear blast arrow. I'm gonna take down that cannon. So that's gonna be. And there we go. So, those kinds of arrows, it takes a while. But basically, what they do is tear apart components. Oh, shoot! Okay. I thought we were gonna die there again. Hello. Yes, if you zoom in, aim, it will slow down.
Is that a skill or something?
Yes, you unlock them further on. There's a skill tree that you can unlock. See easier when it's just one person, so you can just dodge it. Okay, you were not supposed to get out of that area. Yeah, it takes any damage.
You can heal.
Unfortunately, I don't have that. I'm just gonna take off the. There we go. There we go. That one. Can't, because he's still he's still too strong. We have the critical hit, but he's still too strong for us. Let's stay in this area. Maybe we can cheese it. Okay. Let's try to take him down first. This game doesn't have an aimbot, but there is aim assist. Nice. So you won't notice it at first.
This is so dense.
It is dense. I am not the best Aloy out there right now. Oops. That's the problem with the. These, those characters. Got this. Just a bit
more.
I know I'm all alone. I keep falling in that. Oh, it's okay. It's one way too. There we go. We're gonna find a tougher enemy at the end of this for sure.
We're not at the end yet.
We're not at the end yet. This is a really huge area.
Oh.
Don't feel discouraged, we can get through this. So this is just one of the heavy. I didn't see that. Let me show you how it works though. Those are the one of the heavy heavy weapons that you can get. They basically act like modern
modern weapons.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Interesting. You really have to go through. Ah. How are they expected to go up there?
You go up there. By going through the other side.
Yeah, we have to go through the other side. You have more sense of the map than I do.
That's because I'm not playing.
Jew. So see, there's a puzzle aspect in this game. Oh, you can actually climb one of those too. Ah, you can't reach it. You really have to. You have to reach that part. Yeah. There we go. So this is gonna take us on a ride. Or I have to stop here. I have to stop here. Okay, then we're gonna override this one for the bridge. To me, this feels like a military base before everything.
It looks like liquid metal at least.
No, I mean like the cauldrons remind me or make me think that this used to be a military base before everything happened. Whatever caused the post-apocalypse, whatever
probably
caused.
No, but you're not gonna tell us, are you?
No. I'm serious. I'm not gonna. No, but it's enough to make you think that way.
All right.
Yeah.
That should get me through.
Okay. Whoa. Here we go. Now a whole new area is open to us. Now let us back. There we go. Because I haven't been through all the buildings, I can't. I can't be for certain. Can't be really sure what's gonna happen next.
Looks like you're gonna drop
here
again.
Huh?
Oh, it's upside down.
Yeah, but where does this lead though?
I guess that's it.
No, there's something down there. Oh, okay. There's a platform down there. And there's something here too. But that will just take us to the other side.
This side, yeah. That side too.
Aloy feels so out of place in an area like this. This feels more like a Halo game.
Well,
I mean, the level, I mean.
It's bows and arrows versus versus machines. You kind of sort of expect a little bit of weirdness here.
Is it just you? Yeah, they're more of you. As always. Hey.
Your butt's the shot.
There we go. Oh. What is that liquid thing?
Start!
It's just one of them. Don't worry. I hope.
Luckily, the path is lighted.
Yes! Indicates where we're supposed to go. Oh, there's another one. My friend died. What was that? Never gonna do that again. Wow!
Oh, that's an area.
There we go.
I was about to call it Brazilian.
No, because I couldn't hit the eye right. When you zoom in, the aim assist disappears. Yeah, but when you shoot from them without using the zoom, then you can still have that aim assist.
So, when it comes to the game, there's supposed to be three different skill trees, right?
Yes. You want me to show it real quick?
Oh, no, it's okay. I just wanted to ask because my game style is to like call mount and forge a lot. So, did you invest more into battle skills or stealth skills?
I started first with stealth skills, and then from there, when I encountered bigger, more dangerous machines, and not only that, but also the humans, to get to kill humans here too, that's when I thought I should go with a more battle, with a battle tree. Oops, there's one. This game really punishes you if you're not aware of your surroundings. So I would say if you're starting, you can go with the stealth and foraging skill tree before going with the battle skill tree. The stealth skill tree also gives you like Assassin's Creed like moves, which is cool once you start encountering more humans. Oh, okay, so this is the core. I believe this is the core now, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, there's something here though.
Yes. That is a long leg. It's basically a more scarier
like a
version
cyber
of
chicken.
Yes. It's almost like a chicken.
I need them.
It's not easy, but it actually also kicks like a chocobo. Yes.
Well, I don't know.
See, this is the problem when you use that arrow.
It
makes a lot of noise. We're gonna hide over here. There's a vent here, which I can use as a... There we go. I can hide here. Yeah. they're not all attracted to that area. Great. Oh, whoa! I didn't see you! I don't think you can head here, can you? You can.
It's big enough.
Okay. Great. Okay. That is a sawtooth. Down. Now we're gonna use the blade. Huh. Interesting. Let's see if we can take it down for a while. Okay.
Shooting range.
Where is he? As long as he, as long as he doesn't go in, which I have a feeling he will, he did. He ran back. Great.
Well, at least better than dying.
At least we know he's there.
Unless there's a way up there.
And then he figures it out on his own. They are machines. They probably have saved waypoints. There. At least we know one of them's there. Is he still looking for me? He is. Hit me! Alright. Then he's gonna run back. This is gonna be pointless. No, okay. I'm just gonna make sure he's. There we go. This is. Hey! Go back up there!
Oh, you got him.
It's okay. We're up here. We have all of their attention. Gotta watch out.
It's a watcher.
It's a watcher. Oh, he knows where to go. He does know where to go. You know where you're going, sir? Now he's gone. That's
again.
Yeah, that sawtooth is annoying. We have to the first cauldron wasn't this hard. Ooh.
Oh,
got this one
now.
Take that here once we move him in again. Again.
Still using this.
Wow. What?
Oh, he's following you now.
Tense game. This is too tense. Where am I?
Oh, well, he's going back.
Whoa! there. Just runs. Maybe if we just try staying up.
Oh, it's a pool. This is a pool of water. I thought it was more dangerous than that.
I actually thought it was gas or something. Some liquid device. Liquid creature. Wait, how did he call everyone?
Three more shots.
Just gonna wait for it to come back.
You're right.
There he is. Hey! As long as the others don't find me. Hey.
I think there aren't any.
Oh, they are. There are like three.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. There we go. Oh, hey. Sorry, jump again. He did the cat. You would think that the amount of tools you have will make it easier for you to perfectly execute the things you want. But no.
They just make it easier for them to execute you. Yeah. Oh, I think that's it.
I think that's it. You could not head over there.
How did you get there, though?
Hey, there. Well, you can use those.
Override.
Oh, there's one more. Might surprise me when I get them. There we go. Whatever that is. I didn't have one of those. Oh well. All the way over here, and it's recharging.
Well, it's so anticlimactic.
Okay. Let us hope for our sakes that whatever we unlock here.
Is that it? Is that the end?
No. There's another one that we have to override. Okay. Hey, it's a hello. Die now.
Let's get on with it.
Yep, that's good. Then the game surprises us with another Ravager out of nowhere.
I hope not. That doesn't look like a safe spot.
I don't think I should. You didn't catch that the first time.
Okay. Sorry.
That was something. How do you go there?
You're supposed to jump on. Jump on.
Not letting me. There we go. Find a way to process it. Hey. Oh, okay, so we're getting closer now.
That's where I need to go. The belly of this giant beast.
She calls the entire cauldron a beast, by the way. Yes. They're I think they even called the mountain their mother.
Oh yeah, I remember that. Start.
Okay. That made me nervous.
Well, yeah, that would sort of negate quite a bit of progress on our part.
Yeah. Okay, I have to figure out where.
Up there, to the left. See that yellow bit over there?
Oh, there. Okay. Oh, what was that? Those are too fast for me to get on. So, oh, there we go. There's a bridge we can override.
That's where I need to go.
Yes. That's where I need to go. There. So that is the. That is the. That's where. That is indeed where we need to go. Let's wait for the. Let's wait for our.
Charging that?
No. We're waiting for one of those to get here.
Why? You can just.
Can we cross it there?
No, not there. To your right.
To my right. Oh, okay.
That's tricky.
It is. I thought we could just climb one of those floating things. Floating things. Whoa, I don't think we should go. This is toxic gas. It's just the color of the lights. I don't trust this.
Well, we're already here. Might as well take the lead.
Ah, it's just water.
Good.
There we go.
Boss battle?
Ish. Kinda. Let's hope it's not.
Oh yeah, that looks like
it. It is a snap mall. Okay, so this one is a little.
Oh, there are watchers all around.
Yep. Once we override this, there's gonna be another. It's gonna be another batch of beasts, whatever they are, might show up. So. Hopefully, it's a snap mall. Take it. Just be patient. That snap mall is sealed. Hostile already. Other one. This is the last one has another one. There we go. Now we have to go on top of one of those towers. Oh, yeah, I remember. This tower here. Wait.
There's towers that are over right here.
Yes. Let's grab. So nice. Oh, he's looking at me. No, the wall. Prevents it from moving out, but once we override this, it's gonna unlock. Towers are gonna bring us down, and we're gonna have to face a lot of them. Let me just make sure. Let me just make sure we're.
Looks like you're stopped.
No.
Well, at least with enough potions.
We have enough.
This is going to be under.
Is oh no! It had to be this guy. But I could have done. Should have added traps first. Alright then. Have enough time? Right, one of those towers go up. I can't. I think I'm gonna give this one to them. What?
Yeah.
No, it's okay. But I did it the wrong way. Now at least I know that a Ravager's gonna come out. So we can put in traps first. Then
so
we
traps first.
Traps first. Then we
As long as you don't end up starting at the beginning.
No, I don't think we will. Because
that would be unfair.
That would be very unfair. This is not Dark Souls. There we go. There we go. Okay. So we'll take down the Watchers. Then we put down some traps.
Okay, one after the other. Stuff, little one and stuff.
Never mind. Set the traps because that's. I wonder where he came from. He came from the Ravager. So, one down for the Ravager. Funny thing about these traps, even if you cross them,
they won't trigger.
They won't trigger for you. Itself is going to trap every single open angle here. I've been ready to attack.
I'm not good without him.
Yep.
Let's get this fight going.
Proper job. Okay. Let's see the hopefully we pull this off better. Alright. Wanna give it a go?
Oh, it's alright.
Alright, so basically, We're just gonna give this one more time. But at least you already know how difficult these things can be if you're not fully prepared. The last one, the last cauldron that I was able to take down, what took me like 30 minutes to an hour. Or maybe it's just my skill set. But yeah, we're gonna try one last shot at this. And hopefully we do it well. If we don't, we end the stream here. At least you already have an idea that these cauldrons, do not miss them. Because once you do, you'll be able to unlock helpful information for you to override a new set of creatures. There we go, there's our Ravager.
The other one's not dead yet.
Well, there's... Okay, it exploded. But it's not enough to...
He's right.
Hey.
Hey.
Down, the two of you, now. Completely missed it. Oh, if I was able to put it down. Did you spot it? Okay. Okay. Oh, goodness. I think.
You want to do it.
There was an override there. Down. Now. That is enough from you. Where is it?
Oh, back there.
Back there?
There.
Over there. Oh, there. Okay. For you. And we did it.
With level 23 reach.
All right.
Congrats.
So, nice job spotting the cannon. I don't think I would have been alive. We did spot that. Now let's override this and see what machines we can override for this. There we go.
That's it. More machines I can override.
What?
Congratulations.
Let's check out the notebook and see which one to go. There we go. So we're able to unlock the Trampler, Shellwalker, Snapmaw, Longleg, and the Ravager. So these guys, they will not bother us again if we do it right. Alright, so I think that's it. We've shown them the cauldron.
Yep.
And
we've shown you a little bit of the gameplay, some tips, some tricks, a couple of deaths, but hopefully you guys enjoyed it, alright? Yeah. This is Victor Barreto Jr.
This is Nadine Passis.
We're signing off. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to follow Raptor.com and Raptor Gaming League on Facebook.
All Our review is out, by the way, so you might want to check it out on the links later.
All right. Thanks, guys.
See you.